Hi everyone, here is Anton and welcome to my channel. Today we will continue to experiment with the third-party certificate. The topic of today's video is how to replace certificates on the exchange servers. Well, today's task consists of two parts. Firstly, we'll assign the third-party certificate on web services on the exchange mailbox servers. I don't expect any issues, but time will tell. Then I am going to assign the third-party certificate on SMTP servers on the Exchange Edge server. The problem is that we have to preserve a self-signed default SMTP certificate. Otherwise, I will have to recreate the Edge subscription, which will be not so easy in PowerShell script. As always, the result has to be in the shape of fully unattended PowerShell function. Let's start. Here is my function, which installs and assigns the certificate on mailbox servers. The parameters are quite obvious: credentials, which we need to establish a remote CPS session, certificate thumbprint of our new certificate, and name of the server. There is a recommended way to run remote PowerShell scripts. We have to establish a new PS session with configuration name Microsoft Exchange, connection URI, HTTP, name of the server and PowerShell folder, credentials, authentication Kerberos. Then we have to import PS session. It is the official way to connect to the mailbox servers, Exchange mailbox servers. After that, we just run get exchange certificate, looking for the certificate with required thumbprint and enabling it for Internet Information Services. Afterwards, we have to restart Internet Information Services. Quite simple. Finally, I am deleting this session just in case to avoid any interference with our following function. However, with Exchange Edge servers, it is a little bit different. Let me explain a little bit in more detail. Well, issue is that we need to install a third-party certificate to establish a hybrid exchange deployment. In exchange, we can have a number of SMTP certificates and all of them can be used to secure SMTP connections. On the screenshot, letter S stands for SMTP service. But only one of them is default and used to create Edge subscriptions. It is recommended to preserve as default certificates a self-signed certificate, which was generated during the installation of the server. Let me remind you that we need a public certificate to make a hybrid exchange deployment. Thus, we need to install a new public certificate, but somehow answer no on this question. If we do this manually, we just press the no button and do not replace the existing SMTP certificate. However, the enable exchange certificate command does not have the no button. It has only the force key, which replaces forcefully the default certificate. Quite the opposite to what we need. Thus, my strategy was to replace the default certificate twice. The first time with the new third-party certificate, and the second reverse to the original one. But it raises a question: how to determine which certificate is currently the default one? This data can be acquired from the properties of the server in the Active Directory. The link to the article that guided me in this matter in the description of the video. I have to confess that I a little bit overcomplicated the process because I decided to get the information not from the Active Directory but from the Edge server LDAP instance. But the idea is similar. Let me demonstrate this. First of all, we are going to see where is the property. Here is my Exchange server and I just opened etc/edit and proceed to the services, Microsoft Exchange, name of the organization, administrative group, Exchange administrative group, servers, and in properties of the server we can see a property called MS Exchange Server Internal TLS Cert. Unfortunately, it's octet string and very user unfriendly. Thus, we have to use a PowerShell commands to convert it to more familiar representation. How to achieve this? Here is my function devoted to installation of the certificate on Exchange Edge. We are wrapping all our commands into a script block to run it remotely. What I should mention, it is impossible to connect to the Edge server in the same way as to Mailbox server, because Edge server does not have even Internet Information Services installed. However, we can establish a general PS session and import PSNAPIN, exchange PSNAPIN, and run all the commands, required commands. I do it just for in one script block. First line is parameters, then we are importing required modules and PSNAPIN. Creating an object of server. And the most interesting, we requesting current SMTP certificate from the properties of the server. The port is different. Generally, it would be 389, but in LDAP instance accepts connections on 50389. I'm not sure why I did that. It was obviously much easier to get this information from the general Active Directory, not from this LDAP instance on the Edge server. But anyway, the result was the same. And now there is a three strings which lets us to convert this information to more friendly shape. What next? Next, we enable exchange certificate for SMTP with KForce. Otherwise, we will be asked a question if we're sure or not. And then immediately replace the default SMTP certificate back. Next to line, restart services. And additionally, I decided to check if all my Exchange services are running. If not, we are standing them. And finally, just quick check that our certificate didn't change, actually. That we installed new certificate, but default certificate left the same. And final line just invokes this command on the remote server. Probably that is it when it comes to this function. And now we are going to run the script and check if it works as I expect. Okay, let us check the results. I'm going to run both functions. But before, I'm going to replace the certificate for internet services. And for the second server. In case of the Edge, we can only check if our our email messages are passed through the Edge back and forth, and just we'll send a couple of testing emails. Let's run the script. Now it starts to connect to the first mailbox server. Imports session to this mailbox server and starts to replace the certificate. Probably it will take some time. Okay, it seems that the services are restarting on the first server. Actually, have been restarted already. And we are trying to connect to the second server. Again, creating the implicit remoting module, importing PowerShell commands, and enabling the certificate on the server, X2. Again, waiting for the restart of the services. At this moment, it proceeds to the Edge server, the most important aspect of the script. And we can see that it's currently our default SMTP certificate ends with number 4923 and it expires at 1st of March 2026. We are expecting to preserve this certificate. It looks like the script ran successfully. The certificate thumbprint left unchanged. And we are going to check our mailbox servers. Let us see if bindings has been changed. Yes, as we can clearly see, there are our third-party certificate and the second server. The same binding has been changed. And now we are proceed to checking the certificate. Actually, it seems that Outlook cached the process of replacing the certificate. Yes, it's our temporary certificate, but if we restart Outlook, everything will be okay because the certificate has been already replaced with public one. Unfortunately, I am lacking of resources, therefore everything not very swift. Anyway, I am going to send a message to my external email address. And let us check if we received it. It will take a couple minutes, probably. Here my external mailbox. Let me refresh. And check spam as well. Oh, I'm going to delete it forever. Spam deserves it. Promotion as well. So far no errors or any non-delivery reports, but we haven't get our message to. Yes, great. We received it and I'm going to reply to be sure 100%. It will take some time. Splendid! I have got a message, and that means our subscription was not spoiled by this shifts of certificates. And I believe it is success. By way of conclusion, in this video we easily installed the public certificate on the Exchange Mailbox servers via remote connection. There is a supported way to connect to Exchange servers remotely and thus it was not too many difficulties. However, it was a bit different with the Edge server. The Exchange Edge servers do not accept remote connections directly to the Exchange PowerShell via HTTP, like Mailbox server do. Actually, it does not have EES installed at all. Thus we required a workaround. I contemplated two different ways to achieve my goal. Since it is still possible to establish standard PS remote session to Edge server and run any common commands, I planned to copy a small PowerShell script with all required information to the Edge server's local folder, and then run it through the task scheduler. However, it turned out that I could achieve the same result by running the script with a invoke command. I believe you will find this video useful because it seems that people on the internet are not aware of this means to connect to the Edge server and execute Exchange commands. As always, I publish the updated script on GitHub. Please find the link in the description below. In the following video, I am going to update the certificate on all components of the ADFS. See you next time!